Golly gee, I do really love this new prop hunt game mode in Call of Duty World War II.
I really love the whistling mechanic that lets you know where the props are.
Fuck!
That's enough Call of Duty World War II prop hunt for today.
What? It whistled like a prop.
Isn't that a fun way to start a video? If you've never seen a video of mine before, you just saw probably the cringiest possible thing I ever made. Not the intro just then, I actually thought it was pretty funny. But that video of me smashing the computer, it was definitely fun at the time. I regret it heavily now, because I could have sold that computer and gotten quite a lot of moolah. Now, I don't like this setup. Like, I used to really like having all my, like, nerdy shit in the background here, like my Xenomorph skull and my Rubik's Cube that I actually do know how to solve. Maybe I'll release a video on myself doing that one day. Just like my movies and shit, fucking deodorant fucking can, who needs that, right? Basically just like a bunch of nerdy shit. I don't really like this setup though, because I've got, let me just get up on my chair, I've got a bunch of glowing shit right here that you guys can't see, so somehow I'm gonna have to mush you inside this fucking closet, and let's see if we can get an enjoyable view. Something that I don't like about having the camera here though is the fact that I have my PC behind me, like my computer. I'm fine with the PC there because it looks pretty dope when the microphone's not in the fucking way. The one thing that is really fucking annoying though is the microphone setup. So I love the microphone, I love the stand, I love fucking everything about it. The only thing right now is the placement, because of how close it is and because I like to plant my camera right here. It's gonna be pretty fucking annoying. I mean, I could try moving, but like over there, seeing if I can like adjust it or anything. I'll give that a check in a second, but right now I'm gonna go put on a jumper, because in most of my videos I wear a jumper. This is actually kind of better than it was before, because PC back there, monitor right there, microphone right here. Yeah, I guess this is gonna be my new recording setup. Hopefully you guys like it, hopefully it looks good for you guys. And yeah, I think I've been recording for like 2 minutes and I haven't actually gotten into what the fucking video is about, so let's hurry up and do that. So a couple days ago, it wasn't a couple days ago now, it was a couple weeks ago. A couple days ago when I originally filmed the intro to this video, the whole me smashing a fucking computer with an axe, I recently got a new computer. Now the story behind this is that one day I went to my brother and asked where mum was. Now, he said, oh, she's out at the shops getting groceries, which is a reasonable thing. I had no reason to doubt or question it, and I didn't. I eventually heard a knock at the door, and it was my mum asking for help unloading the groceries from the car. Now, obviously, I'm just going to be like, yeah, sure, whatever, groceries, I'll just take them inside. I started heading towards the car, and my mum goes, oh, I spent a little bit on groceries today. And then she kind of looks at me with this face, and I'm like, okay. So I open up the boot, and there's a brand new fucking computer in there. New monitor, new keyboard. New monitor, new keyboard, new mouse, new PC, new speaker system, new fucking everything. And I practically stood there saying, what the fuck, for about 5 minutes. Now, I wasn't angry or disappointed or anything. That's probably a lot of people's, presumptions, accusations. It's probably a lot of people's thoughts when they hear me say, what the fuck? No, I was just in total shock because I never expected to get a new computer. Now, I didn't just get a new computer out of the blue because I whinged and chucked hissy fits and kicked things and was like, I want a new computer, but I never get one. Oh, fuck. No, I'd been having a lot of trouble with my old computer, mainly because it was a really old computer and it wasn't up to current standards on how modern computers run. And with the job that I want to head into in the future, which maybe I'll talk about in a separate video, I need a fast computer. Now, I never directly went to my mom and complained about not having a fast computer and wanting a fast computer. Sometimes I'd come through and she'd be like, oh, what's wrong? You look upset. And I'd be like, well, like, I can't edit on my computer and I'm kind of annoyed. Now, I didn't ever word this in a way like, get me a new computer. I just stated my computer wouldn't allow me to express myself in the artistic way that I like to express myself, which is creating videos and editing. So, out of the blue, or without my knowledge, my mum went to a computer store, I forget the name, I'm sorry, and she started talking about what I do and what I like to do. Now, the best thing that they recommended, allegedly, was a gaming computer. So, this PC runs games, which is fucking dope. Like, I've never had a gaming PC. It wasn't on my list of priorities. I already have a PlayStation 4. So when I got the PC and I found out it was fantastic for editing and gaming, I was like, holy shit, this could be quite a lot for the channel, quite a lot for my schoolwork, and quite a lot for hopefully my future TAFE work. Now, I'm really fucking glad I got this new computer. I love it to bits. It runs as fast as it could possibly run for me. I know there are, like, faster cores out there, and there's probably better graphics cards, and more RAM, and all this other stuff, but the computer that I have is literally perfect for everything that I want to do, and I'm so fucking thankful I have it. Like, I love this fucking computer. She could have just gotten me a regular old fucking computer, but she paid quite a lot of extra money. I'm not 100% sure, but she did pay quite a bit of extra money to get all the glowing lights and everything, just so it even looked pretty for me. She could have just gotten me a basic mouse and keyboard, but she didn't. She got me a gaming mouse and gaming keyboard. She didn't have to get me this mic stand. She could have gotten me a crappy $12 mic stand, which was what I was hopefully going for. I was like, hell yeah, check out this shit on Amazon, a $12 mic stand, that's fucking sick. And she's like, fuck that, we're gonna get the $200 shit. So, one thing I definitely have to say is that when it comes to, like, supporting her kids, my mom she's fucking great at it. Like, she's great at supporting her kids. Now, she doesn't get us this stuff because we want it. It's more or less that we need it. Now, that sounds really selfish, but I kind of want to explain. When I say we need it, I mean for future education. Like, if my brother wants something involving cooking work or metal work or whatever he plans to do in the future, I'm not 100% sure on what that is, and he really kind of needs it, it's integral for him and his education towards a job that he will or wants to eventually acquire, she will get that for him. Like, how the computer is what I need to get the job that I want. I need a computer, I need practice in editing, I need in-depth skills that no regular person should have if I want to get into the universities that I want to get into, or the TAFE courses that I want to get into, all that stuff. The microphone stand, that was a Christmas present, so I guess that's, like, something that I didn't need. I did already have the microphone, but I did need the... Everyone needs a computer these days, oh god. But yeah, I needed the computer, and that sounds like such a first world sentence. God, I fucking hate that. Yeah, this computer is integral to what I want to do in the future, and that future is creeping up on me incredibly fast. I'm in year 12 now. I'm an adult next year, legally speaking. I'm an adult. I have to start voting. I can legally drink. That's about it. But yeah, I mean, at the end of this year, I'm out of high school. Next year, I'm going into TAFE. I'm an adult next year. And that's pretty fucking terrifying, in my opinion. So yeah, future's creeping up on me pretty fucking fast. But I think with all this new stuff that I've got, I'm ready to take it on. job-wise, or, like, academically, I don't fucking know. Basically, I just need this shit for my job. Something I forgot to mention in the initial video is that the computer specs will be in the description below. Hopefully you guys enjoy that and see if you can get an editing computer like mine. Now, I guarantee it isn't the fastest computer ever, but this thing can run Adobe Premiere, After Effects, Photoshop, Audition, all the DaVinci's. This shit can run games like Fortnite, VRChat, Call of Duty Black Ops 3, PUBG, Counter-Strike, whilst running OBS. It does its job, it's good, and it doesn't really strain on it either. The specs of the computer, like what GPU and CPU and graphics card and all that shit it has, will be down in the description. Hopefully you can get some enjoyment out of that. I just felt like I should put it in there because someone would want it. So now that I've got the fact of me actually getting the new computer out of the way, I kind of want to talk about why I smashed my old one. Now, I kind of regret smashing my old computer now. I definitely could have given it to a friend, but I did offer quite a few friends the computer for free, 100%, completely wiped hard drive, new slate, new keyboard, fucking everything, just secondhand computer. But nobody really wanted it, mainly because it's from like 2011, 2010, 2009. It's really old, doesn't work too well, it's slow, even when I factory reset it, compared to modern computers, it's slow, and a lot of my friends have modern computers, so they didn't need an old one literally slowing them down. So, instead of thinking, hey, I can sell this, my instant thought was, I can make a video, which definitely shows that I have my priorities straight. And yeah, I basically called over my friends, and I was like, hey, let's make a video, and they were like, what are we gonna do? And the first thing my mate suggested, because we're so interlinked, was smash that fucking computer. And we all laughed for about 20 minutes, coming up with ideas on how or why I'm smashing the computer. My idea was to just, like, smash the fucking computer because I was pissed off. But we eventually culminated the idea that we'd base it off a current video game, like Gmod Prop Hunt, except this brand new thing came out. Someone just swore. This brand new thing just came out in Call of Duty World War 2, a game mode called Prop Hunt, which is practically exactly the same, except every couple seconds, the prop whistles. Now, I was like, oh shit, the prop whistles. That's how you find the prop. And then my mates and I were like, so we can have the computer whistle, pretend it's a prop, chase it, and kill it. And we were like, yeah, but there are reasons it's really bad acting in it. Like, I don't know about this, but I've been told by drama teachers, and they're supposed to be supportive, so I wouldn't 100% take this into, like, belief. But I've been told that I'm a fairly okay and decent actor. So the people that you see in that clip who are acting, although I'm the only real one acting, the only other people are just smashing my computer, it's purposefully bad. I don't like making skits like that with effort, because it's just a waste of it. If I want to make an actual skit where I'm sending a message, or I want to be actually comedic, not cringy comedic, then I will put serious effort into it. But I wanted this video to be cringy, and to be stupid, and to kind of just point out the fact that, yeah, I'm smashing a fucking computer with an axe, which is one of the dumbest things that you could ever fucking do. And like I said, I'm kind of regretting it now because I could have gotten a bit of moolah. Hell yeah. I think someone's getting fucking murdered in my kitchen. I'm going to be right back.
Sink, faggot.
Bitch.
That works.
So no, it doesn't look like anyone in my house is getting murdered. I think I've basically covered everything I wanted to in this video. Basically, why I got the new computer. Why I smashed the old one. So, yeah, that's the basic rundown on why I smashed a computer with an axe. Moving on to a completely different topic. This is going to be the last couple things I talk about before I end the video. I was just wondering if you guys wanted to see some gameplay. I've definitely been collecting Fortnite gameplay, not only on my computer, but on my PS4 as well. I've been getting some hilarious fucking shit. And I wanted to know if you guys want to see it. If you do, comment down below and I will release some gameplay footage. I won't do a funny moments or anything. Maybe I'll do like a compilation of a bunch of different games. Or I'll upload a video and then I'll put gaming segments in between it. I don't really know how it's going to work. You guys can suggest that as well. I'll take into consideration what you say. And yeah, if you guys want to see gameplays, fucking comment like you never do. You cunts. In all seriousness, I take that back. I love you. Hopefully you guys have a fun little day. Never know how to fucking end this, so I'm just gonna put some clips of my brother doing stuff.
Yeah? Seth? Hmm? Seth? Be louder, I can't hear you. Mm hmm.
Sorry, no, chair rage shopping. Yeah, I don't want anyone.
Stop it, cat. Cat, stop it. She's trying to get in the cupboard. So, stop it! Ooh. Oh, that has some chunks in it.